not had it recently, keep us it. I've just played our Meerkats their final feed of the day just now. We're getting one of their new toys for them, which will keep them busy for a little bit longer. Hopefully make the food last for a little bit longer and keep the brains going a little bit. So here at the park we've got 7 Meerkats as well. It's a non-breeding family group, so that consists of Mum Layla, which is this one here, and her 6 babies from a few years ago. So she's had 2 separate litters. The first litter is 6 years old now, and the second litter is 5 years old. So these are, with there being 7 of them, it's a slightly below average group size for if you were to compare with their wild counterparts. The average in the wild is about 10 or 12 meerkats per group. However, you can also see them in super groups in the wild of up to 50 members. So their group size can actually vary quite a lot. No matter the size of the group, the infrastructure is still the same. So there's an alpha male and an alpha female. And it's only those two that are actually allowed to reproduce within the group. They can breed upwards of 3 times a year, having between 4 and 6 pups per litter. So they could effectively increase their group size by 18 meerkats a year if they really wanted to. One thing meerkats are very good at is controlling their own numbers. So if they've already got quite a big family, or there's already quite a lot of mouths to feed and they don't want extra competition, and they don't necessarily need to make their family stronger, they'll simply choose to not reproduce. Although it's only the alpha pair that can breed, the subordinate members are expected to actually help with the rearing of the other of the babies and stuff. So the elder male meerkats will mentor the baby boys, and the elder females will mentor the baby girls and teach them how to become meerkats. Every now and again you might get a cheeky chap who's a subordinate member that wants to try and have some babies and sneak them in. So they'll occasionally try and sneak them up into the alpha pairing's litter, or they'll even challenge for that dominant role. This is a very risky game for them, so they need to be almost certain they're going to win. If they don't win that battle, they will be exiled from the family group or even killed by the alphas. If they are exiled from the group, there is very, very little chance of survival on their own, and it's also unlikely another meerkat group will accept them as well in the wild, which is why they have to be really certain they are actually going to win if they do challenge the alphas. Sometimes when the alphas are getting a little bit older, they might have to be quite responsive and maybe give up the alpha role just so they can stay living in that family group at a lower ranking to live out their days. Now all of them are down on the floor at the minute, but throughout the day you might see meerkats up from one of the higher points. It's called being on sentry duty, so whilst doing the middle rock or even sometimes at the top of the log, they're basically on lookout and they're being a security guard for their family, checking out for any potential threats or predators. There's always meerkats on sentry duty during daylight hours in the wild. And all they are looking out for is any potential threats or predators. So they go to the highest point so they can see further out. And they can also look up directly into the sky as well. Now the meerkats, they do have a number of different adaptations to deal with the deserty environment that they do live in. Now some of these include the really long claws that they've got. They're really good for digging through all of the sand. They've also got crescent shaped ears. They can open and close those ears at free will, which is something they also do when they're digging through the sand. They don't want to get sand stuck in their ears, so they'll close their ears off. And then they've also got these dark rings around their eyes as well. That's effectively like them wearing a pair of sunglasses. So on a really bright day, they can look up directly into the sky and they won't be blinded by the glare of the sun due to the darker rings around those eyes. That's really important for them to be able to see potential birds of prey flying over that might cause a lot of threat to their family. Now the meerkats do take it in turns on sentry duty, so it's not the same meerkat all the time. They do it in a little shift pattern. If anyone on sentry duty sees a potential threat, they'll let out a barking call, and that puts the rest of their family on a high alert status. They'll all go check out the threat together, and if it's something that becomes a more realistic threat, they'll either prepare themselves to fight it off, or they'll run to the safety of their burrows. Meerkats can actually burrow underground. Our meerkats have built their own burrow underneath the rocks in the middle of the enclosure as well. And they do have the house to my left here, which they also use. When they do build their burrows in the wild, they go down on average about 1.5 metres deep, and they maintain quite a good temperature underground for the night. And they also build them with several different entrance and exit points, just in case anything decides to wander down in that burrow while they're still there. They do provide themselves with a few different escape routes. At the minute, meerkats aren't actually a threatened species. They are doing quite well, but there are a few threats that are estimated to happen in the future for them. One of these threats is the exotic pet trade, so they are becoming a more popular household pet. They don't really make too good of a pet, in my opinion. They are actually quite smelly animals to start with. They're also highly social. They need a lot of space and need to live in quite a large group. Another threat to them is actually themselves as well. So because they are living in such tight-knit family groups, when they keep breeding and breeding, there's a chance of more wild inbreeding going on, which over a period of time may start to shorten the lifespan of each group, and this is when they may start to struggle. So there are currently some efforts going on into trying to re-release some genetically diverse meerkats and try and get them into some of the wild groups to help potentially alleviate that as well. But as you can see, that toy hasn't lasted horrendously long. They've got all the food out of it already, pretty much, apart from a few biscuits, which they are their least favourite food anyway, so they do go last. So I'm going to leave the meerkats in peace now, but if you do have any questions while you're here, please don't hesitate to ask. Again, my name's Reece, I'm going to stick around for a little bit after this as well. We will be closing the animal side about 4 o'clock-ish today, just due to the dropping light, but the indoor areas of the park are open until 5, so if there is anything you want to go and see before we start to lock up, I'd recommend going up now. But other than that, enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you.